Are you looking to build yourself an incredible, very fun, mana overpowered 50 to 100k squad? You came to the perfect video. I enjoy this team a lot. I think you do as well. Give a thumbs up if you love it. Subscribe for more. Put on the notification bell. And if you click the I button, you can find hybrids and squad builders for every single budget. 50, 100, 200, 250, 500, 1 million K. It's all there for you to reach out and touch by clicking the I button. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe for more, and then you join the incredible Viva La FIFA army. If you are ready to win every single game in FUT 22's ultimate team, but you're out of coins and you want to get the player you always dream about, don't worry, head over to u7buy.com using my link in the description, and don't forget to use the code VIVA for an extra 5% discount. On the bench, I'm putting a 500k hybrid I'm using myself in the weekend league, in Division Rivals, in Division 1, and they are just phenomenal. I'm using Manuel Neuer as a goalkeeper, center back Upamecano, left back Alphonso Davies, then down the right hand side I have Jules Koundé as a center back, right back Jesus Navas, his road to the final card, Frankie de Jong is my center mid, I'm completing the midfield, trust me, there will be full chemistry, the left center mid is Tunguy Ndombele, the center mid is Paul Pogba, striker Fekir, left wing Heung-min Son, right wing Ousmane Dembele, and then I'm using Vidal and Lozano as well as super substitution. So you can use this team if you have 500k to build. Enjoy it, you love it, and you get a lot of victories, easy peasy. Well, enough said and done, now go to the first starting 11. Starting the episode off with the goalkeeper of Manchester City, and that is, yep, Ederson Moraes. You can downgrade him if you don't have the money, but then you have to go for a goalkeeper like Nick Pope, for example, but then you're struggling with the full chemistry on the left center back. More about that later on. So I'm using a Brazilian goalkeeper to, well, get the best out of it. With Ederson, you get something that you love. 89 rated, a superb sweeper keeper, amazing coming for crosses, and his reflexes are also insane. The downside on Ederson is his handling. Is that important? No, you don't need handling. Reflexes, positioning, that's what you want, plus the diving. Ederson has it all to make. On the left-hand side, we have Eder Militao. You can also change another center back like Diego Carlos, be my guest. It is depending on what you like. I'm going for Eder Militao. He's a very quick player, has agility, 82 speed. You can boost that even higher with a shadow card or an anchor card. So be my guest, do what you want. I'm increasing his defending and positioning with a guardian card because I think his speed is already good enough. You might say, hey, I'm a speed abuser. Well, once again, be my guest. Use the team, but the chemistry styles, I leave it up to you. The left back position, it depends on your budget. If you have more money to spend, you can go for Ferland Mendy. Great signing, the right back and the left back are top level. If you don't have the money, we're downscaling it. You can go for Renan Lodi with a shadow card, and it also matches the ability of Ferland Mendy, and he's, well, almost 20 times as cheap. If it's not even more, maybe even 50 times as cheap. So, well, if you have to make a decision, staying within budget, Renan Lodi is your man. If you have the budget, you guessed it, Ferland Mendy should be your choice. One of my personal favorites in this video is Yannick Ferreira Carrasco. To be positive, guys, if you want to stay within the 50k budget, you should go for the normal Carrasco. If you're going for around 100k, Yannick Ferreira Carrasco, first inform card, can be your man. 86 rated. His agility, his flair, his quick feet feel like Ousmane Dembele down the right hand side, and you know how good Ousmane is this year. So if you're building yourself a La Liga side, for example, I would recommend a good striker that can be whatever you want. Right wing, exactly, Ousmane. Left wing, Yannick Ferreira Carrasco. Make them cut inside, stay central, and enjoy the victories. So thank you, Carrasco, for all the beautiful things you're giving us. The left center mid is rule breaker David Silva. 25k, just like Marco Arnautovic, you can get yourself two rule breakers in a budget of 50 to 100k. Isn't that cool? And that with Carrasco, his inform card as well. Well, in game, I would make a CDM play instead of Sansone. opponent, go for a good CDM. For example, Frank Cassie or Vidal. That's good enough. Then you can play in a 4-1-2 formation with four at the back, one CDM, a left winger, a right winger. On the camp position, you put David Silva and then two strikers. So actually, you're switching to a 4-1-2-1-2 formation. So if you don't listen to this video, like some people do, they click to the end, they build it, and they don't listen. They're using Sansone all the time. They're not subbing off John Stones. But if you're one of the lucky people that is smart to listen to the video, it will get you way more wins. On the right center back position, I have to go for John Stones. To get full chemistry in this squad, two players are not the best. And I could recommend you guys, if you're starting the game, you can also switch them off. I wanted to go for Joe Gomez, but I couldn't reach full chemistry. Unlucky for that. So with a player like this, we can do that. Stones is there. Try Joe Gomez if you don't mind playing with a little bit less chemistry, because Joe Gomez, in my opinion, is way better. So what can I say about John Stones in this video? Nothing very spectacular. He's just there to get the full chemistry in a very fun squad. Well, this is one of the reasons why he's here, for Ederson Moraes and Kyle Walker. With 25k, Kyle Walker is one of the most expensive players in this episode. You saw him on the thumbnail, but Kyle Walker is everything you want and so much more. Great in attack, great in defense. He is Ja Cancelo in combination with Wan-Bissaka. The attacking power of Cancelo and the defensive power of Wan-Bissaka. So look no further. If you have 25k to spend on a right back, it should be Kyle Walker and nobody else. Trust me, guys, he will be a game changer for you. If you lose games just by one goal, with Kyle Walker, it could switch the difference to winning it by one goal. That has had a huge impact he makes on that put. Moving on with Enrico Chiesa. Chiesa is speed, skills, and goal-scoring abilities. And he might seem nothing, just a gold card, just a high-rated gold card, but trust me, he is so much more than that. When I'm facing Chiesa in Ultimate Team, I know one thing for sure, trouble is coming to me. Imagine if this guy gets a Futmus card, gets a new card in the future, then Chiesa will be one of the most used players in the game. You can take poison on that, because Chiesa, his 83 rated card, already feels like magic. Imagine him exactly with an even higher rated card. Then everything I told you, you will say viva. Exactly, you were right about it. And then I can only say, guys, well, I told you so. So try him and enjoy. Just like John Stones, Sansone is here for one thing and one thing only: for the chemistry. So if you like to take him off at the start of the game to put in a player you like more, like Frank Cassie, Arturo Vidal, I have him on the bench, for example, those players will be fine and they do a better job. I think Sansone, in all honesty, if he hadn't played for Bologna, he would never be able to touch a spot in this video. But Sansone is there, and I will tell you why in a couple of seconds. The left striker is Iñaki Williams. Well, you have to stay within budget, 50 to 100k. It depends on when you buy, when you sell, and Iñaki Williams is a super cheap OP player. I would not put Hunter on him because his speed is already good enough. I would upgrade his shooting. So with a finisher card, for example, Iñaki Williams is not only a speed tank, but also a player that will get you a lot of great finishes in and around the penalty box. And yes, unluckily, many other players already, well, are further in the process. They got special cards by EA, so he is not used all the time anymore. But still, Iñaki Williams feels like a very OP meta card. And to complete the team, we have Marko Arnautovic. Arnautovic is unbelievably cheap. 25k. Yeah, viva. How is that possible? I don't know. He's hard to link. You see, I need Sansone to get Arnautovic on full chemistry in a hybrid. You can use a full Serie A squad, be my guest. But in a hybrid, if you have any other solution to link him with better players than Sansone, drop it in the comment section. I thought about Alaba, he's also from Austria. I thought about several other players, but I couldn't make it. I couldn't make a team, a hybrid like you love, with Marko Arnautovic without Sansone. So Sansone, thank Marko Arnautovic, and back to Arnau. This guy in real life is crazy. His brain cells are just reduced by 50% when he was born. But with his rule breaker card, EA made a big difference. You know, we some Ben Yedder guys, FIFA 2019, 2020. You know him, don't you? This is exactly we some Ben Yedder, with physicality and a strong body. Well, I think that tells the whole story. Arnauta Veach is an icon card for me, hidden in disguise. So thank you, Marco, and now I will tell you how to play with this squad. Let's go to one of the most important things to make this team successful. Well, we're going for a drop back. Well, it might sound like everybody does that, but it works the best with this squad. The width and the depth, don't touch it too much. In the build-up play, I'm going for a slow build-up play, keeping possession, because that way you won't get hit by counter-attacks. And players that drop back all the time, you can keep ball possession all the time as well. Players in the box, put it back. You don't want to be hit by counter-attacks. Same for corner kicks and free kicks. So what can you change about player instructions? Here it is. If you're watching my hybrids, my squad builders all the time, you know the drill. Goalkeeper, come for crosses, sweeper keeper. Ederson is one of the best in the world to do that. Center backs, stay back. Full backs, stay back. Center mids, stay back. Left wing, right wing, cut inside, come short, because that way you can always play the ball when players, well, your opponent, I mean players, are dropping back, and you always send them in behind. Nobody's there to pass the ball to. And then we have the two strikers. One of them I like to play as a target man, Arnauta Veach, and Iñaki Williams using the room in, around, behind, before, almost on top of Marko Arnauta Veach. So in that way, you can have yourself the best possible team. So now some action, guys. What is nice to play with? Of course, from the center back positions, always played down the wing, or look to play to one of the center mids like David Silva. But your wingers are very nice. They're quick, they're reliable. So if you can get the ball as quick as possible to Arnauta Veach, then the fun will begin. Then we have Carrasco running within space. Chiesa running within space. Same can be said about Iñaki Williams. And then David Silva can play as a playmaker around him. And that way, you create yourself so many opportunities, so many beautiful moments, that this team will make you smile from ear to ear. So if you love the videos, give a thumbs up. Subscribe for more, put on the notification bell. That is all I'm thanking of you guys. If you do that, thank you very much. And click the I button for a new video already. If you do that, thanks a world. You're just amazing. I hope to see you soon in a couple of seconds if you click the I button and a new playlist.